first picked up me. I'm a support engineer at CyberTech, working with Kari here, and I've been helping others in Postgres at CyberTech for 5 years now. And I have been helping myself with Postgres since 7.4 days, and I ran out of fingers counting how many years ago that was. So I've seen some stuff about Postgres. So what are we going to talk about today? We're going to talk about Patroni, which is a tool to build high availability clusters with Postgres. So if you want to look it up, Google it, or here's the GitHub link where you can install it from. During the talk, all questions are welcome. I will maybe say if the topic is coming up later, but otherwise I will try to answer them as questions come up. So what's the state of the art in Postgres clustering? I have heard many complaints that Postgres doesn't do clustering. And on the other hand, we have pgpoll2, we have pacemaker clusters, we have replication manager and so on. So why Patroni? Just an example of the way to fix the problem of having too many standards is to make another one. But all of those other tools suck, at least for me, so I needed something that was slightly simpler to use and wasn't a huge pain to debug when things go wrong. So I joined the Zalando guys in developing Patroni for clustering. So, what is Patroni? To talk about it first, let's look at the high availability problem for Postgres as a high-level overview. So, there are three things that are needed to build a high availability cluster. You need to figure out when some node has failed. When it has failed, you need to promote the new master, and you need to route your clients to the new master. If you have robust pieces for all of those problems, then you can do a high availability cluster that works with pretty good uptime. So if there are so little pieces, why is it tricky? Postgres does single master replication, so you have one node that is master, and the streaming replication and replicate all the changes to other nodes. And if you have a situation where you have two nodes that are master, then that is actually worse than having no masters, because then different clients can write into different databases, and trying to put that together is not possible automatically. You basically need to manually figure out what changes went where, and it's a complete nightmare. Usually people just say we'll lose some of the data and we'll try to fix it. We'll re-enter some of the data and manually verify. So we need a way to agree on who gets to be master. It sounds simple, but you have to account for the fact that servers can fail, networks can fail. And sometimes stuff fades in a way that it kind of works, but not really. So a server goes away for 30 seconds, then comes back, or network only works one way, or packets are duplicated, and all kinds of interesting stuff can happen. So you need some way to distinguish server failure from network failure. And figure out, do we need to shut ourselves down, or are we alone now and we need to be master? And that is a complicated problem. And there are some algorithms that are specially invented to solve this exact problem. So they are called distributed consensus algorithms. So two main algorithms that are known are Paxos and Draft, and they are pretty tricky to implement by yourself. There are distributed databases that I can do it for you, so So we have things like etcd, console, or zookeeper that provide you with a database that has multiple masters, and all writes are consistent all over the cluster. This means that they are actually quite slow, so you can't actually use them to store user data. And they don't have many features, they're simply key value databases, basically. This is enough to provide us with a way to agree on who gets to be master. So, how Patroni does solves the problem of doing high availability. You will have a Patroni agent running on each database node. And the Patroni agent will run a loop that every 10 seconds or whatever you configure checks if health of the local Postgres instance is okay, and if the cluster is okay, and if a cluster, for example, has lost its master, then it will try to become a leader using the distributed consensus store to ensure that nobody else will do the same thing at the same time. So, if you start Patroni, what will happen? You don't actually have to have a database installed or initialized. Patroni will do that for you. So, one of the nodes that you boot up will get to initialize the database, runs initdb, and then the rest of the nodes will use pgbase backup to get a copy of the database that was initialized. And then the Patroni will monitor the health of Postgres instances on all nodes. And if Postgres goes down, it tries to restart it. If an existing master is fails, then a new master will be promoted. And other standbys will be redirected to the new one. And if the old master comes back, for example, after a crash, so the server rebooted due to a power failure or something, then you need to run something like pg rewind to bring it back up. I will not go into details why this is necessary, but you will most likely get errors if the server is under any load before the crash. So your Patroni will automatically rejoin crashed nodes back to the cluster, which is quite neat. What Patroni does not do is handle the routing problem. So clients need to somehow find out which database they need to connect. There is no proxy in Patroni, and it doesn't do virtual IPs. You need to give leadpq, which is the Postgres client library, some host to connect to. And in Postgres 10, leadpq can actually, you can give it a list of hosts, and it can figure out on its own which one is the master and connect to that. But for now, you need some proxy in between. And also, JDBC can do the same thing. So if you have only JDBC applications, you don't even need to solve this issue externally. You can do it in the client. For other issues, you need a load balancer to do the forwarding. So Patroni provides an HTTP API that gives a load balancer a health check that it can use to figure out which node is master and which one is not master. And you can use whatever load balancer, so HA proxy or Nginx, and to avoid those two load balancers becoming a single point of failure, you can do a simple virtual IP failover between those load balancers, which is a lot simpler than doing failover between databases, because load balancers have no state. Or you can run the load balancer on the application server and just connect to localhost. But large head installs quite commonly have an existing load balancer, something like F5 BVIP product or some other commercial tool. Or if you are running in cloud, you have stuff like Amazon Elastic Load Balancer, whatever your cloud provider gives you. Or you can do the load balancing on the client. So here's a small picture of how all those pieces fit together. So if you have two database nodes, Patroni will connect to consensus store, etcd in this example, and will start Postgres, make it replicate between two nodes, and then provide health checks to the load balancer so it knows where to direct the user. And if one node goes away, Patroni notices this and promotes the other node. Any questions so far?
What about little ones? Does it use a synchronous replication?
You can configure it to use synchronous replication.
And in case of asynchronous?
In case of asynchronous, you lose a couple of seconds or whatever your lag is.
You can configure it actually, how much data
yes,
like, will you want to lose and still switch over automatically?
So the master, every time it runs the loop, it stores its transaction log position mm-hmm. in the consensus store. And when standby comes up, it can check this and figure out that, okay, I'm like 20 megabytes behind, and we don't want to promote in this case. Better to go down than lose that amount of data. So you can actually configure how much are you willing to lose. And if you are willing to do zero, then we have synchronous replication mm-hmm. support, and in a way that can actually leave the, if one node goes down and you only have two nodes, it will disable synchronous replication, but if the single remaining node goes down and the other one comes back up, it knows not to promote the other one. So you can do synchronous replication with zero data loss and still keep availability mm-hmm. in case of one node remaining.
Can I use console as consensus store?
Yes. And we have had some bugs with it which shows that there are not many users using console, but
we will be vocal.
But there are at least a couple of people who were reporting bugs, for instance, so there I think now are users already using console. I can't say anything about the quality of the zookeeper implementation. It's automatically tested, but you know, automatic tests don't cover everything always. There can be issues. Let's do a live demo to make things interesting. So, etcd cluster for development or testing, you can set up a local one. I will not cover how to run etcd clusters, but it's not really that hard. You need to just ensure that quorum is always maintained, and if you lose it, you need to take some special steps to bring it back online. Already installed here. Let's run it. We have etcd running. Okay, next step. We need to set up Patroni. So, simplest way to do it is using pip install. I usually use a virtual environment so I don't pollute the operating system level global scope with extra packages, so I have a self-contained directory of everything I need. But you just do pip install Patroni and then get a sample configuration which you can download from the GitHub repository, for example. edit it and then start Postgres or start Patroni on the config, which will start Postgres. So let's see. He already had downloaded it, the config here. It has stuff like scope, which basically is the name of the cluster. Namespace is something you don't need to worry about. It just allows you to run multiple clusters with the same name or the same etcd cluster if you need to do production and testing or stuff like that. But the second really important name is name of the node. And then you have a bunch of IP addresses that you need to configure. So for the REST API, you need to set up what it listens on and how can other nodes connect to it. Where is etcd running? Then you have some bootstrap information which tells Patroni how to set up Postgres. This information is stored into the distributed consensus store, and is the initial configuration. So you can set Postgres config parameters here, and so on. You have here you have initdb options. You probably want to run with data checksums so that pgug wipes as well. You can also configure it using wall log hints. But if you are logging hints anyway, checksums are basically free. So it's recommended to turn this on. And the HPA conf settings are set up at the initialization time. This is copied into the conf a single time, and afterwards you need to edit the files directly. Or you probably want some configuration management tool to deploy those changes. You can have Patroni set up some users, and then you have Postgres settings which are local to this node. So listen address, connect address, data directory, and authentication information is not stored in the consensus store because security reasons. It's not a wise idea to put all passwords in a single database. And you can, if you want to configure some detailed behavior. This is the example config for Patroni's site. And now we will just move from it. Source the virtual environment, but now.
People's house.
This virtual environment. Just marking my path. Installed. you can now see that initdb is running. And now initdb has completed and Postgres has started. And every time Patroni runs through the high availability loop, it will show some information that who is the current lock owner. And what action does it want to take? So maybe in the second we tell this to kill minus 9 Postgres. And now we are again running as master. So let's add a second node to the cluster.
Is it possible to apply Patroni for existing databases?
No.
Is it possible to apply Patroni for existing databases?
Yes. Easy.
Is it easy?
I don't have an example here already, but it's reasonably simple. So, to do the second database, I have here Postgres 1 YML. So, let's see the differences. So, basically, we only have changed the name. And listen and connect addresses data directory. You can add them. You don't have to actually change data directory per node. I'm changing it here because I'm running it on a single host. Okay, so it bootstrapped from an existing database and it now use run pgbase backup to start up, to clone the new instance, and it started up. Now it's saying that the lock owner is Postgres 0, I am Postgres 1, and everything is fine. I am secondary and I am following Postgres 1. Patroni control is actually a remote command that uses the REST API, so you don't have to actually run it on the same node that the databases are running at, which may be useful. And here we see the current state of the cluster, and if you want to do a failover, we run Patroni control failover admin. It asks us from which node to where we want to failover to, when do we want to do it, and then confirms if everything is as we think it is. And what happened now is that Postgres 0 was stopped, Postgres 1 was promoted. And now Postgres 0 should be back up soon. Now it's back running, replicating Postgres 1. Okay, so that's how you set up a simple cluster. Here is an example how to set up a load balancer. I'm not maybe going to go go through it right now. I will put the slides up to the user group site so you can see how this works. But setting up a load balancer is pretty simple. There is actually a template inside Patroni repository for confd, which is a daemon that pulls etcd and gets the list of cluster members from it, deploys it to a configuration template. So you get the ha proxy config out from the directly from the etcd database. So you can automatically configure the load balancers in this way. For other products, you probably need to develop your own solution for that. Or do it manually if you are not adding a huge amount of nodes. So, any questions about the demo or anything else you would like to see?
Questions. So, besides, I would like to know like contributors for the project.
Zalando.
Huh?
Zalando.
Ah.
Is the main contributor. And there are, I think, a couple of other people who are using it and are starting to develop on it.
Maybe you can also actually describe a bit more why. Was it started, or what is the big advantage of Patroni? In that sense, that this compared to pacemaker, for example.
Yes, pacemaker is, I think, the main competitor. Other solutions have the main issue that they don't work, so which is not something you want from a high availability solution. But pacemaker does work if you configure it correctly. And that's a big if. It's pretty tricky to get it right, and if you don't get it right, you get to go through tens of megabytes of logs to figure out why stuff's not working.
Yeah, exactly. So because this pacemaker is a generic framework with lots of XML, it's pretty old, and configuring it, like, it will take hours and hours compared to minutes here, so when you want to get Postgres running.
It's a more generic tool, so pacemaker you can use to also run Apache, and maybe you want to have LDM mounts on your database nodes to do backups or whatever. You can do those things with pacemaker quite easily. They already made adapters for all kinds of stuff. But being generic means it's complicated.
And also, I think pacemaker doesn't allow you to automatically reprovision the old masters into slaves. So,
if you have a failover, you need to manually intervene with the pacemaker, which might be fine for some installs, but for many locations, especially stuff like Zalando, where all development teams are running their own clusters and they don't actually have access to the database machines, it needs to just work. And having the requirement that after each failover, somebody needs to connect to the database and bring the old master back up again, it's not acceptable.
How does it work if the Union Egress application was introduced in Minecraft or something? So then the master set up. So how do you, like, then you don't have a single master and
Patroni does not handle logical replication and BDR, which is doing the multi-master thing. But BDR is not something you would want to have for high availability.
Yeah, so it has its trade-offs, but...
So, because it's not consistent multi-master, it's asynchronous multi-master, which means you need to have conflict resolution. It's complicated, and we usually do it for geographically distributed databases where many sites that usually get disconnected or work completely offline for a while and then rejoin the cluster.
Is there any way to, if a failover happens, to have something automatically do something, like a script that can...
Yes, there are hooks for on role change.
I see.
So you can detect when this is starting, stopping, or changing from standby the master. Then you can could possibly actually do the IP migration from
right.
those hooks. Or run some local script that just pulls and sees if I am master, then move the IP here.
Right.
In many cases, virtual IP movement is actually not acceptable because you don't have the nodes are not in the same subnet. And you cannot actually use virtual IDs.
Right.
Move over automatically.
The demonstration was amazing. So actually with a single YAML file you create database, replication and whatever else.
Yes.
Actually it's automation on the required level, but what will happen if some problem will happen? What to do for me, for example?
You call Kybatte for
call us. The logs are reasonably sane. And the tool itself is written in Python, and if you need to dig into it, it's also understandable. If you have some development experience, you can actually go into it and understand it. It's not that huge. And conceptually, it's quite simple. You have a state chart, or decision chart, which shows how the loop works. Let's see if I have it. And it reports its decisions in the log in a simple way, that why did it decide to become a master or not become the master. Maybe I will go over how we avoid split brain, which is the main complex issue with HA solutions. So how Patroni works is all nodes try to acquire a leader key in DCS, which is basically write their name into the leader key store, and the key has a timeout, which is by default 30 seconds. And the master runs a loop that checks if Postgres is running in the master, and if everything is okay, and if everything is okay, updates the time to leave the key. So if the distributed consensus store gives an error back, Postgres gets demoted. If the access times out, we get demoted. If we discover that somebody else got the key, we also demote Postgres. Demoting basically means stop Postgres and start it up as a standby. And if the leader key expires, other nodes will wake up and see, okay, last time Postgres 0 was master, let's see what he is doing. They will try to contact Patroni on that node. So even if for some reason the key goes away in the DCS or in etcd, the others will still check the previous master, maybe it's still alive. And if it's still alive, they will not promote themselves. And as an extra layer, if Patroni itself goes down, then you would have a load balancer that runs the health checks, will have the health check fail, and it will remove that node from the load balancer rotation, so the clients can access it. And in future versions, pretty soon, we'll have kernel watchdog support also. So if Patroni does not work, then the operating system will just reboot itself. And this will ensure that if something went wrong in a way that nobody thought of yet, then the system will just reboot and we don't have multiple masters at the same time. And for the leader elections. If there is no leader key, then many nodes, and as I said, check if the old leader is still there, then check all the other members and see which one has the most transaction log. And the, only the ones that are furthest ahead, that are closest to the old master, will get to become the new leader. And they will also check if the master was too far ahead. So if a standby wakes up a day later and discovers, oh, there is no master, it will not promote itself, but it will wait for the real master to come back.
One question. What happens still if I kill minus 9 this Python Patroni process? It's the database, Postgres is a sub-process.
Depends on how you deploy it. So, normal deploy, as I demonstrated here, where you just run it as a separate process in a normal operating system, then Postgres will keep running, except for the watchdog support that I mentioned, if you kill minus 9.
But then you have the possibility for split brain and stuff,
yes,
and all the bad stuff.
Another way to deploy Patroni is as a Docker container, with Patroni running as the process number one. If Patroni dies, the whole container will get killed with the container manager. So that will ensure that Postgres goes down.
And this was the original use case actually, to be used with Docker. So Salamander guys more or less meant it to be used.
You can deploy it also on Kubernetes, but you need shared storage. That work, so you can. Kubernetes doesn't have a solution for global storage right now. So that's not a Patroni problem, but a Postgres problem. Just Kubernetes has the way to say that store stuff on a local disk and try to bring things back up for the same network.